So today's the day. I got the new capacitor in. I got it yesterday, actually, after I left here. So, I don't know if you can see in the background, I spent all day building shelves. Generator a little closer than I normally like to, only because I'm going to need it to run a short cord out to the generator. So this is pretty simple. It has spade terminals, and it doesn't appear to matter which one goes where. That's going to go in there. It went like that. Still has some capacitor juice on it. Which, by the way, my son found the term capacitor juice very funny. I guess as a 3-year-old, a lot of things are funny. And I just want to make sure that's not all pushed up against the end. I'm going to short out. So the other thing that we need to do is this cord does not have a ground, and I want it to have a ground. I don't know why I left them on that side. So we're going to snip this off, see if I can get this off in here. See if these will cut that, and they should. So those of you, because I know there are some of you who watch from other countries, some of you may have never seen a U.S. standard plug, or aren't familiar enough with it. My understanding is, like, in Europe, in school, they actually teach you how to do these plugs, or how to do the standard ones. Just want to get something real quick. Alright. So with a plug this way, don't forget to do this. I forget to do this all the time. Run your cable through. Run your cable through first. These are not wire strippers. I thought these had wire strippers in them. You don't really need to get a whole lot of the insulation off. You really don't want it in there anyway. I was just trying to see if somebody important had messaged me. I am waiting on an important message. Try to not go too far down. There we go. Alright, so from the back side, with the pin facing down, this one here is the black or the neutral. The other one is white or hot. And then the last one on the bottom is brown. And there you have it. goes in somewhere. It only goes in one way. And that's not there. That's the way.
I like it.
Sorry, I won't do that again. Actually, I probably will. Alright, so I'm going to go pause the video for half a second. Go plug my other quarter into the generator. And then I will only then come in and plug it in here. Alright, so you're going to see just as well as I'm going to see. And it just blew it out again. It just blew the, and there it is, all the, let's see if I can get you to zoom in. See, that's all the juice from the, generator, or from the, capacitor. So I'm gonna, I don't know if it just doesn't like this generator. Oh, God. Whew. Now bear in mind, this was a $7 capacitor versus, you know, a name brand. But my God, that stinks so bad. It's the exact same values as the original one. I don't understand what's going on. Well, to answer your question, no, I cannot fix my generator or my compressor right now. I thought maybe not having the ground pin was the problem, but it might also just be the motor. So I'm going to try to find out if I can get a whole new motor. But it looks like for now, I'm stuck with that little generator, or that little compressor. I don't know why I keep trying to say generator. Anyway, whew, man, that stinks so bad. In more than one way of the, I'm saying it. Anyway. Thanks for watching. Have a blessed day. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.